SpaceX's Starship program continues to march through a fluid set of milestones, ranging from a new record number of Raptor engines firing simultaneously. Booster 7 achieved the 7-engine static fire test milestone, before rolling back to the production site for robustness upgrades. It is set to return for its pre-launch flow this coming week. Booster 7 and Ship 24 continue to be cited as the pairing that will conduct the orbital test flight, with Musk citing the latest schedule as, late next month, October, maybe, but November seems highly likely. Schedule clarity will be gained via the upcoming return to Booster 7, from its time back in the Mega Bay, High Bay 2 after it was transported away from its perch, on the orbital launch mount, in the middle of September. That rollback came after achieving new milestones, not least the most amount of Raptors ever to be fired at the same time. The 7-engine firing was deemed a success by Musk, with rollback to allow for robustness upgrades ahead of flight. With road closures posted for the upcoming week, work on Booster 7 in the Mega Bay is likely coming to a close over the weekend, which in turn keeps to the schedule Musk noted for a potential November flight. Our focus is on reliability upgrades for flight on Booster 7 and completing Booster 9, which has many design changes, especially for full engine rudder isolation, Musk noted in a tweet. That's the plan, Booster 7 first to fly. We're taking a little risk there, as engine isolation was done as retrofit, so not as good as on Booster 9, Musk added. Musk has indicated that those upgrades might involve fortifying Super Heavy Booster 7's thrust section, to ensure it can survive Raptor engine failures. With 33 Raptor V2 engines powering it and plenty of evidence that those Raptors are far from perfect reliability, the concern is understandable, even if the response is a bit different than SpaceX's norm. Prior to the start of preparations for Starship's orbital launch debut, SpaceX sped through Starship development like it wanted to destroy as many rockets as possible, which, to some extent, it did. Rather than spend 6 to 12 months fiddling with the same few prototypes, without a single launch attempt. SpaceX churned out Starships and test articles and aggressively tested them. A few times, SpaceX pushed a little too hard and made avoidable mistakes, but most of the failures produced large amounts of data, that was then used to improve future vehicles. The holy grail of that project was high-altitude Starship flight testing, which saw SpaceX finish, test, and launch a new Starship 5 times in 6 months, and culminated in the first fully successful high-altitude Starship launch, and landing in May 2021. In comparison, SpaceX's orbital flight test preparations have been almost unrecognizable. While a good amount of progress has been made in the 16 months since SN15's successful launch and landing, it's clear that SpaceX has decided against taking significant risks. After spending more than 6 months, slowly finishing and testing Super Heavy Booster 4 and Starship 20, the first orbital class pair, SpaceX never even attempted a single Booster 4 static fire, and unceremoniously retired both prototypes without attempting to fly either. Without info from Musk or SpaceX, we may never know why SpaceX stood down B4 and S20. Or why the company appears to have revised its development approach, to be a bit more conservative after clearly demonstrating the efficacy of moving fast and taking big risks. It's possible that winning a $3 billion contract, that places Starship front and center in NASA's attempt to return astronauts to the moon, has encouraged a more careful approach. SpaceX won that contract in April 2021. Even in its more cautious third phase, Starship development is still extraordinarily hardware-rich, moving quickly, and uncovering many problems on the ground in lieu of learning from flight tests. But that doesn't change the fact that the third phase of Starship development 2021 today is proceeding more carefully than the first. Nonetheless, SpaceX appears to finally be getting closer to Starship's first orbital launch. According to Musk, the company could be ready for the first launch attempt as early as late October, but a November attempt is highly likely. He believes that SpaceX will have 2 pairs of orbital-class Starships, and Super Heavy boosters, B7 and S24, B8 and S25. Ready for orbital flight by then, potentially enabling a rapid return to flight after the first attempt. Musk is also excited about Super Heavy Booster 9, which has many design changes, and a thrust section that will fully isolate all 33 Raptors from each other, crucial for preventing the failure of one engine from damaging others. Meanwhile, as Musk forecasted, Super Heavy Booster 8 rolled to the launch pad on September 19, and will likely be proof tested in the near future, while Booster 7 is upgraded back at the factory. Encouraging as that may be, history has shown that reality, particularly when it involves Starship's orbital launch debut, can be quite a bit different than the pictures Elon Musk paints. In September 2021, for example, Musk predicted that SpaceX would conduct the first Super Heavy static fire at Starbase's orbital launch pad later that month. In reality, that crucial test occurred 11 months later, August 9, 2022, and used an entirely different booster. This is to say that significant progress has been made in the last few months, but SpaceX has a huge amount of work left, almost all of which lies in uncharted terrain. Starship 24, which completed its first six-engine static fire earlier this month, is currently undergoing strange modifications that seem to imply that the upper stage is not living up to SpaceX's expectations. It's unclear if additional testing will be required. Super Heavy B7 is headed back to the factory for additional work after a successful 7-Raptor static fire. Once it returns to the pad, the sequencing isn't clear, but SpaceX will need to complete the first full Super Heavy wet dress rehearsal. Fully loading the booster with thousands of tons of flammable propellant, and the first full 33-Raptor static fire. It remains to be seen if SpaceX will continue its conservative approach, i.e. testing 1, 3, and 7 engines over 6 weeks, or jump straight from 7 to 33 engine testing. It's also unclear where Ship 24 fits into that picture. SpaceX will eventually need to, or should, conduct a full wet dress rehearsal of the fully stacked Starship and may even want to attempt a 33-engine static fire. With that fully fueled two-stage vehicle to truly test the rocket, under the same conditions it will launch under. Will SpaceX fully stack B7 and S24 as soon as the booster returns to the pad, risking a potentially flightworthy Starship during the riskiest Super Heavy tests yet? SpaceX's last year of activity suggests that the company will choose caution and conduct wet dress rehearsals and 33-engine static fires before and after stacking, potentially doubling the amount of testing required. One or several more tests will also be required if SpaceX decides to gradually build up to 33 engines, which is the approach that all Booster 7 activity to date suggests SpaceX will take. Either way, it will be a major challenge for SpaceX to have a fully stacked Starship ready to launch by the end of November. If any significant problems arise during any of the several unprecedented tests described above, Musk's predicted schedule will likely become impossible. As a wildcard, the Federal Aviation Administration has yet to issue SpaceX a license or experimental permit for orbital Starship launches, either of which is contingent upon dozens of mitigations. This isn't to say that it's impossible for an orbital Starship launch attempt to occur in November. But factoring in the many issues Booster 7 and Ship 24 have experienced during much simpler tests, it's becoming increasingly implausible SpaceX will be ready to launch the pair before the end of 2022. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.